वीडियो कैसे मिडिल वन क्यों रहता है वीडियो वन इज क्यों रहता है टीवीओ कैल्केनियम मिडिल वन इज क्यों रहता है टीवीओ कैल्केनियम मिडिल वन इज क्या है टीवीओ कैल्केनियम नाउ सो वी हैव गॉट द थ्री फाइबर्स नंबर वन इज एंटीरियर सेकंड इज मिडिल एंड थर्ड इज पोस्टीरियर सो व्हाट अबाउट द पोस्टीरियर द पोस्टीरियर वन इज फ्रॉम द टीबिया राइट अप टू द कैलस Go from the tibia right up to the talus, and so this is known as the tibio-talar ligament. This is known as the tibio-talar ligament. Tibio-talar ligament. This is not post tibio-talar ligament. So we have got three fibers. One is the anterior, second the middle, and third one is the posterior one. So anterior we have got. The navicular, you can see over there, this is the navicular, we are, this is the anterior one, this is the posterior, this is the medial side, this is the medial side of the ankle joint, we are doing from the medial side of the ankle joint, so this one is the navicular bone, so the fibers from the tibia, lower into tibia, going into the navicular, this is known as the tibio navicular fiber, tibio navicular band, or tibio navicular ligament, a part of the superficial band of the deltoid ligament. So this is the talonavicular, the anterior one, the middle one going into the calcaneum. So from the tibia right into the calcaneum, this is known as tibio calcaneum. And the third one, that is the posterior one, going into the talus. So from the tibia to the talus, this is known as the tibio talar ligament. This is known as the tibio talar ligament. This is about the three fibers, three bands of the superficial ligament. Regarding the tibio-calcaneum, this calcaneum band is attached to the on the superficial surface, superior surface of the calcaneum. We have got the sustensna pulum cari. Sustensna pulum cari. Talus is attached to the calcaneum over there. So this sustensna on the margin of this, on the whole length of the sustensna pulli, this tibio-calcaneum fibers are attached. Now regarding the talus, will come very shortly. Where it is attached to the talus. Now this is attached to the medial tubercle of the talus. Now this is the talus view from the superior. This is from top view. We are viewing the talus. This is the anterior end. This is the posterior end. This is the medial and this is the lateral end. So on the posterior end of the tibia of the talus, we have got two tubercles. One is called the medial tubercle and other is called the lateral tubercle. So this medial tubercle and lateral tubercle, any between the two, we have got a tunnel, and this tunnel is called the flexor hallucis longus muscle. This tunnel is meant for flexor hallucis longus muscle. Now, this medial tubercle will be attached to the posterior band, posterior fiber of the superficial part of the deltoid ligament. The deltoid ligament will get attached to this point. This is called the medial tubercle. The deep part, superficial part has been now the deep part. Deep part has got only one fiber, that is from tibia to talus. This is called tibio talar. For the tibio talar. See, the posterior portion is being occupied. This is the posterior end. So posteriorly it is being occupied. So this deep fiber will go to the anterior end. This deep fiber will go to the anterior end, and this will occupy the anterior part of the medial surface of the talus. This is the this is the medial side of the, this is the medial side of the talus, and you see over there, this is the medial side of the talus. This is the one is passing for the navicular bone. We have seen the navicular bone over here, and this is the neck of the, this is the head of the talus, and this is the neck of the talus, and this one is the superficial surface, and this medial surface, medially we have got the attachment of the anterior tibiotalar ligament, anterior tibiotalar ligament. So the anterior tibiotalar ligament is attached to the anterior tibiotalar ligament is attached to the medial surface of the talus, medial surface of the talus, and the posterior is attached to this one, that is the medial tubercle, that is the medial tubercle. So this is all about the, this is all about the deltoid ligament. We have read about the deltoid ligament. Now coming to the relations. This deltoid ligament, this deltoid ligament is crossed by, this deltoid ligament is crossed by the tibialis posterior muscle, flexor digitorum. This is crossed by, this is crossed by the two muscles, the flexor tibialis posterior muscle and the flexor hallucis longus muscle. This is flexor hallucis longus, flexor hallucis longus muscle. So these two muscles, that is the tibialis posterior and flexor hallucis longus and flexor digitorum longus, flexor digitorum longus, flexor digitorum longus, tibialis posterior and flexor digitorum longus, two muscles crosses the deltoid ligament. These two muscles crosses the deltoid ligament along with the posterior tibial vessels and the tibial nerve, along with the posterior tibial vessels and the tibial nerve. Function of this ligament, what is the function of ligament? The first function is that it is a bond, it is a adhesive, it is a heavy wall between the tibia and the bone of the foot, and the bone of the foot, because it is attached to the navicular bone, it is attached to the calcaneal bone, it is attached to the talus bone. The three bones of the foot is being attached to the tibia. So it attaches the tibia to the bones of the foot, but the superficial fiber which is attached anteriorly, the superficial fiber, this prevents the forward gliding of the foot, and the deep fiber prevents the backward gliding of the foot or the leg. So these are the functions of the functions of the deltoid ligament. Now we are left to one ligament, that is known as the lateral ligament. That is the lateral ligament. So we will draw first the lateral ligament. talk about the lateral. This deltoid ligament, this is the medial ligament. Now we have talked about the lateral ligament, and the lateral ligament is also a strong ligament, and this ligament is not divided into superficial or deep. Simply it has got the three parts. The number one is known as the anterior tibio calofibular ligament, second is posterior calofibular ligament, and third one is the calcaneofibular ligament. So these are the, if you view from the lateral side, if you view from the lateral side, this is fibula, this is callus, this is calcaneum, this is navicular bone, this is cuboid, this is anterior metatarsal. So this is the fibula. So from the fibula, the fibers which are going towards the anterior end of the talus, this is known as anterior calofibular ligament. The middle one which is going towards the calcaneum, this is known as the calcaneofibular ligament. The posterior end is going towards, again, the posterior end of the talus, which is known as the posterior calofibular ligament. Posterior calofibular ligament. This side is related to the peroneus longus and peroneus tercius. The peroneus longus and the peroneus tercius, the two most important muscles, will be seen around this side. So the peroneus longus and the peroneus tercius, they are the two muscles which we can see on this side. So they are the. We should conclude this one, and now we move towards the relation of the ankle joint. Now we move toward the relation of the, there are the few, this is the gross anatomy. Now we will talk about the relation. Now we will talk about the movement, the stability of the ankle joint, and the clinical anatomy of the ankle joint. So from the medial to the lateral, this is the medial, this is the lateral. From the medial to the lateral, the four important structures which are related to the superficial end of the anterior part of the ankle joint. This is the anterior part of the ankle joint. You view from the, this anterior, this is superior, this is inferior, this is medial, and this is lateral, and this is medial. So we are going from the front. This is the anterior side, and for anteriorly, we talk about the anterior part. So the four structure which are important is the tibialis anterior. The next is the extensor of hallucis longus. Third one is the extensor digitorum longus. And fourth one is the peroneus tercius. So the tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus, and peroneus tercius, they are the four important structures related anteriorly to the ankle joint. We talk about the medially. We have already talked about the tibialis posterior and the extensor. Tibialis posterior and flexor digitorum longus. We have talked about medially tibialis posterior and flexor digitorum longus. Both the tibial, posterior tibial vessels and posterior and tibial nerve. So these are the tibialis posterior, flexor of digitorum longus, posterior tibial vessels, tibial nerve, and flexor of hallucis longus also. These are related to the medial side. They are related to the medial side of the ankle joint. Now regarding the lateral side. Now posteriorly is related to the gastrocnemius and the soleus, and gastrocnemius and the plantaris. And regarding the lateral side, laterally it is related to the two muscles which are peroneal tercius, which become like this, and peroneal longus. So peroneus longus and tercius on the lateral side,